How do you feel in Munich, because the city doesn't have any high rises at all?
Well, you know, we're very happy to be in Munich, and we really like the German aesthetic and technology-based aesthetic, because that's very close to what we as a firm believe in. You know, we strive for something. We have three things we look for: simplicity, structural clarity, and sustainability. And that seems to be the basis of German architecture. So, you know, we're very comfortable being here. We're glad to be here.
And I think that some of the same principles that are used here in the city, especially with the work of Freiato at the Olympic Village and Stadium, where the use of minimal material to manage load is in buildings, whether they're tall buildings or long span buildings, the principles are the same. So we reflect on these developments in terms of our ideas, new ideas for design. So we hope maybe someday that the buildings get taller in Munich, at least in the outside of the historic area, perhaps. And I think there are some good examples around the world that show us that can be done. So we'll see.
Okay. What do you think about European historical grown cities and high rises? Does it fit together or doesn't work at all?
Well, you know, an example there is London, where they, in the medieval city, they've done a lot of tall buildings, and there I think it does work. You know, this combination of special buildings next to ancient guild halls, there it does work. But I can see where it couldn't work everywhere. And so, you know, I think it's a case-by-case basis, but that's certainly an accessible example. Is it appropriate for everywhere? I'm not so sure it is, okay. But I do think that there's room for modern architecture in the historical centers, and purely the juxtaposition of very modern, clean, efficient, new architecture next to a historical thing makes them both more interesting, in my opinion.
I think that infrastructure is absolutely key to this idea, and you can see great cities around the world that have plans with great infrastructure, whether it's the movement of people, movement of material, energy, water. These things, when they're in place, like they are in place here in Munich and other cities like London or New York City, the city can organically grow from that central idea. And it's the places around the world that's not in place, where the building comes first, that we see the highest risk. So we embrace these ideas, and some of the things that we're thinking about in terms of structures and architecture that you see are appropriate for buildings, we think are actually appropriate for the plans of the future in terms of optimizing the flow of people, density, and efficiency. So we think these principles could actually apply to maybe bigger plans.
Is there any project or any plans, if you could choose freely, that you want to realize, or a special city where you still want to build, if you could choose freely?
Well, I've never done a building in Germany anywhere, so that's a start. I'll take a whole country for that. For me, it's not a question of scale. So one of my most favorite buildings I've ever done is a 10-story building. You know, so I've done 160 stories, I've done a 10-story, and those are my two favorites. So it's not about scale. One of Mark's most famous projects is a cathedral. You know, it's a one-story, I guess.
Yeah. Which one?
It's the Cathedral of Christ the Light. It's actually it's part of the exhibit here. Yeah, it's built in California. And we use wood, which, as you know, we're thinking of wood in tall buildings as a material that can regenerate. And I think that one of the things for us, I believe, is that the goal of, I'll say, carbon neutral construction, whether it's the time that you build or it's the operation of the building, and probably more importantly, it's regeneration, the idea that the building would give back. So if we had to design maybe the smartest building that we could, it wouldn't be just a building that consumed, it would be a building that would actually give back in some way, whether it was water or energy. And the principles that we use perhaps lead us to minimizing its footprint when we first build it, but then also thinking about it over its life and you know, Kendallwoods can maybe part of cities that actually give back. So those are the things I think that we're thinking about beyond whether it's super tall or not so tall. Yeah.
Thank you.
Sure.